Earlier today, the president met with congressional leaders. Senate Republican leader Mitch McConnell said the president briefed them on Iraq and told them he did not believe he needed authority from Congress for the steps he might take, and said he would keep them posted. Even before that, White House Press Secretary Jay-Carney gave his farewell briefing here in advance of the meeting of the congressional leaders. Carney made it clear that in the view of the administration, the crisis in Iraq is up to Iraq to figure out. And he did say the U.S. continues to review its options and that the military option remains on the table, but that U.S. troops will not be sent into combat in Iraq this time around. That still leaves open the possibility that the president might order airstrikes, though no decision has been made on that.
Any action that he might contemplate when it comes to direct military, the use of military force, would be to deal with the immediate and medium-term threat posed by ISIL, and to make sure that our first and foremost objective in the region, which is to deny extremists a safe haven, is pursued and achieved.
One big concern here is about the United States cooperating with Iran on a response to the crisis in Iraq. Congressional Republicans expressed bewilderment that the administration would even consider such an idea, though Jay-Carney said there would be limits to what the U.S. would agree to.
I can tell you that we are open to engaging the Iranians, just as we are engaging other regional players on the threat posed by ISIL in Iraq. Any engagements we have with the Iranians will not include discussion of military coordination or strategic determination about Iraq's future over the heads of the Iraqi people.
The running debate now is about whether Iraqi Prime Minister Nouri al-Maliki ought to stay or go. However, at this stage, it seems somewhat academic. Carney said it's up to the people of Iraq to choose their leaders, and the United States will deal with whomever they pick. Joe John, CNN, the White House.